Good morning. Welcome to Victoria's Faith. I'm Cherry Campbell. We are now in a series called Kingdom Finances. And yesterday, I was talking to you about our heavenly account. You have a heavenly account. You have an account in heaven. And we read these scriptures in Matthew chapter 4, verses 14 through 17. It says, now Paul was writing to the church at Philippi, who had been in partnership with him, he said, yet it was good for you to share in my troubles. Moreover, as you Philippians know, in the early days of your acquaintance with the gospel, when I set out from Macedonia, not one church shared with me in the matter of giving and receiving. Notice it's not just giving. Giving and receiving, except you only. For even when I was in Thessalonica, you sent me aid again and again when I was in need. Verse 17, underline, mark this, color it, highlight it. Not that I am looking for a gift, but I am looking for what may be credited to your account. So you see, Paul was telling the Philippians they have an account. Every single one of you, every individual, you do share things maybe with your spouse in heaven, but you also have your own account in heaven. There is an account for every Susan Jones and for every Joe Johnson or anybody else. You have your account in heaven with your name on it, and it records all that you deposit in that account. Hallelujah. Now, also, Jesus said it in Matthew chapter 6. Matthew 6, verses 19 to 21. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust destroy, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where moth and rust do not destroy, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. Now, I do not believe that God is telling you you can't have a bank account. I don't believe he's telling you not to have a checking account or a savings account. I don't believe he said not to have a 401k or to put any investments in stock. But he is saying don't put your faith and your trust in it. And we will see that in other scriptures also. Do not put your trust in money. Do not put your hope in the money on the earth. Because moth and rust do destroy. Now, what is rust? We mentioned yesterday, it's corrosion. Corrosion, deterioration. Well, how does that apply to money? Money value deteriorates. A dollar today does not buy as much as a dollar would buy 100 years ago. At one time, a dollar could buy a pair of shoes. And then it took $10 to buy a pair of shoes, and then $50 to buy a pair of shoes. Now it can take $100 or $200 to buy a pair of shoes. Why? Because the value of the money has deteriorated. But in heaven, the value of what you have given never deteriorates. So the value of what you gave is recorded. So if you give, like I said yesterday, if you give $20 to a missions project, and you give in love and faith and obedience to God, then the value of what that $20 was to you is what is recorded in heaven. I mean, just think about when Jesus watched the widow woman put in two mites into the temple offering. And there were all these rich Pharisees putting in large sums of money. And this little widow woman came in and gave two mites. And Jesus said, this woman has given more than everybody else because she gave everything she had. Now, that gives us another clue, another key, or another principle of kingdom of God sowing that I want to just quickly point out to you. It's also based on percentage. It's not number amount. $20 is being recorded in heaven. No, it's value. And it's really, in addition to value of what it is in your economy, that it's that, because it applies to its value to you? What is its value to you? And it's based on percentage. If you give something more valuable to you, then it will be recorded in heaven at a higher value. Because the two mites that little widow woman gave was all she had. She gave more than everybody else, because she gave 100%. It was percentage. So what is the value of what you give to you? It's not the same for everybody. $20 to one person is not the same as $20 to another person. Because $20 to a person who has $1,000 is not very much. But $20 to a person who only has $20, or to a person who has only $40 or $50, is a lot more value to that person than to the person who has $1,000 or $10,000. So God records what you give according to its value to you. So what its value means to you is the recorded value in heaven. Hallelujah. And therefore, it doesn't matter what the economy is. It depends on what is its value to you personally. And that's according to what you have. That's why Paul also wrote in 2 Corinthians, it's according to what you have, not according to what you don't have. So you give according to what you have, and you give what is valuable to you, and that value of what its worth is to you is what it's recorded in heaven, in your heavenly account. Amen. And then we saw also in 1 Timothy 6, now wait a minute, I want to back up. Matthew 6, where it says, do not store for yourselves treasures on earth. We see that treasure on earth, money on earth, can deteriorate. We know the stock market can go down and up. It can decrease. People even have lost their 401k, lost their retirement, lost their stock investments. They've lost a lot of stuff. Why? Because earth's economy is uncertain. But if you store your treasure, what's valuable to you in heaven, it will not decay, it will not deteriorate, it will not lose value, and it will never disappear. It will stay there, it will remain there, and it will build. It will always accrue interest. Yes, there is an interest system in the heavenly banking economy, but it is interest based on the 30, 60, 100-fold that Jesus talked about in Mark 4. He said, this is what the kingdom of God is like. In the kingdom of God, a man who sows seed in good ground produces a harvest 30, 60, and 100-fold. So the kingdom of God banking system has an interest system of 30, 60, and 100-fold. You will never match that in any investment on earth. So it's not wrong. I told you it's not wrong. There are Christian investors, and praise God. God bless you, Christian investors. I bless you in the name of Jesus, and I believe you can be used by God and be part of the hand of God to do what the Bible talks about, the wealth of the wicked transferred into the hands of the righteous. God can use you. You can work in that world system to gather money to the kingdom of God. That's fine. And you can invest in stock. You can have a 401k, all of that. But do it by being led by the Holy Spirit. As I shared the testimony yesterday, there was a man who heard about being led by the Spirit and how God can turn $50 into $1 million. And so he began being led by the Spirit in stock investments, and he became a multimillionaire because God taught him. I know of other stories that the same thing has happened. The preacher I told you about, and there's others. They invest where God says invest, when God says invest, and they make money and they don't lose. And when God says get your money out, I know of a man that just before the crash, well, I don't remember if it was 2008 or 7, I think 8, that when the stock market went down, that God, everything was looking good. Everything was good. Everything was looking just perfect in the economy, everything was good. But God said, take all your money out. Cash in everything, all your investment, 100%. Said, okay, God, he cashed it all in. And it was like a week later that everything collapsed. God warned him. You can use the world system, but you need to follow the Spirit. So God can warn you when to move, what to do, and when to get out. But as I said yesterday, Paul used this phrase when he talked about love. He said, but I will show you a more excellent way. There is a more excellent way than the world system, than stock market. It is the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God is safe and secure. The kingdom of God will never be robbed. The kingdom of God will never have an economic stock market crash. There will never be deterioration. There will never be decay. There will never be decrease. Everything you invest in the kingdom of God, or I can say in your heavenly account, is safe and secure forever and ever and ever. And it is increasing continually on an interest rate of 30, 60, and 100 fold, according to your love, faith, and obedience to God. And so we see it also in 1 Timothy 6, verses 17 through 19. And Paul said, command those who are rich in this present world. And I said to you yesterday, don't discount yourself from that. Don't think that that's somebody else. Like I said yesterday, on a world standard, all Americans that are even middle class are rich. In God's kingdom, we're all rich. You are rich. Count yourself in on this. Command those who are rich in this present world not to be arrogant, nor to put their hope in wealth or their trust. That's what Jesus meant in Matthew 6 when he said, don't store up for yourselves treasures on earth. He meant don't put your hope and your trust in the wealth on earth, which is so uncertain, but put your hope in God and sow your seed in the kingdom of God, who richly provides us with everything for our enjoyment. Matthew 6:33, seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, his ways, and all these things will be added to you. In God's kingdom, it is a secure, safe, and sure way to invest, and God will take care of you. God will take care of your needs. God will richly provide you with everything for your enjoyment. And he will, all these things will be added unto you. But it includes all the things of operating in the kingdom of God. It's not automatic. Your harvest will not dump on you, fall out of heaven. You have to learn to operate the laws of the Spirit, even for harvesting, for claiming. In other words, I'm going to get to this later, but an account has rules. Even in a banking account system on earth, there are rules for depositing money in the account, and there are rules for withdrawing the money out of your account. Now, some people think that what's in heaven is only available after you go to heaven, after you die and go to heaven. Wrong, wrong, wrong. You're not going to need it after you go to heaven because God has everything for you. You're not going to need what's in your account. You need what's in your account now, here. This is where you need to reap it, on earth, because God takes care of all your needs already in heaven. You need to know how to withdraw from your account while you're on earth. But let's finish 1 Timothy 6. Verse 18, command them to do good, to be rich in good deeds, and to be generous and willing to share. In other words, don't just work the world system of working, investing, stock markets, 401k, retirement fund, vacation time, but be rich in good deeds, generous and willing to share. In other words, operate the system of giving and receiving. That's what Paul said in Philippians 4:15, in giving and receiving, giving and receiving. Verse 19, in this way, they will lay up treasure for themselves as a firm foundation. And the King James says, laying up in store for themselves a good foundation against the time to come, against the time to come. Now, that's like what the world would say. You're laying up for yourself a secure financial foundation for the future. A secure financial foundation for the future. That's what the world will tell you. That's what the stock investors will tell you. But this is God's system for laying up for yourself treasure for a secure financial future. It's in the kingdom of God, and it is in sowing and reaping. Now, the kingdom of God is safe. It is secure. There's a detailed list and record of everything you give, and it is recorded according to the value of what it means to you, of its worth to you, because the worth of an item for one person is different than its worth to another. $20 to one person means more than $20 to another. So according to its value and worth to you is what's recorded in heaven. Heaven has a good record keeping system. There are rules that govern the depositing in the account, and there are rules for governing withdrawals. Just like when you go to the bank, there's a way to make a deposit and there's a way to make withdrawal. Now, think about this for the withdrawal part. You don't go in to the bank here in your town and lay down on the floor and cry and beg, oh, please give me my money. Oh, please give me my money, and kick your feet, scream, or just even lay there and cry and beg. Oh, please, you know that I need the money. Oh, you know that I need the money. Oh, you know I need the money. Oh, please give me the money. They say, get up off the floor. If the money is in your account, then write a check for cash or fill out the withdrawal slip and we'll give it to you. There's a legal process for withdrawing. A lot of Christians go to God. Oh, God, please give me the money I need. Oh, please give me the money. Oh, God, you know I need the money to pay rent. Oh, you know I need the money. He knows you need the money. But there's a legal process. Fill out the withdrawal slip. Write the check for cash and cash it in. That's how you withdraw. Now, I'm getting way, way ahead of myself. We're talking about that later when we talk about withdrawing. But that's just a clue to clue you in. The earthly system is a picture, a pattern of the heavenly system. There is a heavenly bank. You have a heavenly account. There are heavenly records of your giving. And there is a heavenly process for depositing. And there is a heavenly process for withdrawing. And you don't go in to God and just cry, oh, please, I need money to pay rent. Oh, please, give me the money to pay rent. He says, I know you need the money. Withdraw from your account. Follow the process for withdrawal and we'll give it to you. It's yours. I mean, that's what they say to you down at the bank here in town. It's yours. It's rightfully yours. It's there. The money is there. Just make a withdrawal whenever you need it. Just cash in a check for it. There's ways to withdraw from your heavenly account. You need to learn the rules for depositing. Learn the rules for withdrawing. It is just the same in heaven as it is on earth. But the thing is, you don't have to wait till you get to heaven to access the treasure in your account, the wealth that's stored up in your account. You don't have to wait to go there. You can withdraw it here now while you're on earth. This is where you need it. I use sometimes this example. You know, let's say we have a bank, and I'm going to use a different country. So let's say we have the Bank of England right here in town, right here, let's say in Denver. The Bank of England, there's a branch, or let's say the Bank of London. The Bank of London there's a branch office in Denver. And let's say that you have opened an account at that bank, the Bank of London, at the branch office in Denver. And not only that, but the Bank of London has ATM machines in every supermarket. Just pretend with me. Pretend. There's a Bank of London ATM machine. ATM machine in every supermarket. It's in your neighborhood right down the street from you. And you've got an account at the Bank of London. Do you have to go to London to get your money? Of course not. You just go to the local ATM machine. Do you get it? You do not have to go to London to get your money out of the Bank of London, because there are branches and there are ATM machines on every corner in every supermarket. You just go right down to your nearest supermarket and go into your ATM machine and stick in your debit card, and you make a withdrawal from the Bank of London. The Bank of London is in London. You're in Denver. You don't have to go to London to get your money. It's exactly the same way with the Bank of Heaven. The Bank of Heaven is in heaven, but you don't have to go to heaven to make a withdrawal. There are ATM machines right in your house, right beside your bed, in your breakfast chair, right under your nose, your mouth. Your mouth is an ATM machine. You begin withdrawing money. You don't have to go to heaven to withdraw from the Bank of Heaven. There is access to the Bank of Heaven from any spot on the entire earth, wherever you are. If you're in the middle of the jungle in Africa, if you are in the middle of the jungle in Central America, or if you're in the middle of the jungle in Vietnam, or in the bush of the South Pacific, or if you are in the urban cities of Denver or Chicago or Dallas, any spot on earth, you can access the Bank of Heaven. You can make your withdrawal without going to heaven, because we're in the same kingdom. Remember, the kingdom of God is on earth as it is in heaven. Jesus said in his prayer, "Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven." And Jesus said over and over again, the kingdom of God has come to you. The kingdom of God is here. We're in the kingdom. So you don't have to go to heaven to get from the bank. You can get it right here on earth. Now, I also just touched on this, sharing with you some of my personal experiences of operating in the system of sowing and reaping versus the world system. Now, let me lay this out for you real clearly again. In the world system, there is the world system. Yes, we talk about stock market and investments, but how do they work? They actually work by buying and selling, buying and selling. The world system and economy, the whole financial structure of the world system is based on buying and selling. That's even what you do in business. Business, commerce, trade, it's all buying and selling, buying and selling. Even when you work for a company, you are employed, you are an employee of a company. What are you doing? Buying and selling, because you are selling your time and knowledge and strength. It is part of your life. And what do they give to you? They give you money. So you have sold part of your life. You have sold your time to work and your knowledge to work for them, and they paid you money in return. There's the system of buying and selling. You are even selling hours of your time, or you are selling your knowledge when you are working, and people pay you. So they are buying, you are selling your knowledge and your time. They are buying it. They are giving you the money. So the world system operates on buying and selling, but the kingdom of God operates by giving and receiving. You see, God does not sell anything. God does not sell anything. He gives everything he has. He just, remember, we looked at Luke 15, and the father said to the son, older son, "My son, everything I have is yours. It's yours. I give it to you." The Father gave his son, Jesus Christ, for all the mankind. The Father gives us salvation. He gives us righteousness. He gives us healing. He gives us supply and provision. That's why even Matthew 6:33 in some translations, all these things will be given to you as well. Given added to you as well. God gives you everything he has. He does not sell you anything. So the kingdom of God system is a system of giving and receiving, sowing and reaping, seed time and harvest. And that's why I shared personal testimonies. For example, and I'm running out of time, but when I was in Indonesia and I needed an international airline ticket, I met a man talking to me, talking with a group of us, and he said he needed a $50 domestic ticket to fly home. The Holy Spirit spoke in my heart, and the Holy Spirit said to me, you buy his $50 domestic ticket for your international ticket. And my international ticket was going to be like over $1,000. And God said, buy his domestic ticket to reap your international ticket. So I paid $50 for his domestic ticket. And then God provided for me an international airline ticket. I operate in the law of sowing and reaping in this kingdom of God system. And that's what I'm showing you. Whatever you need, you can operate in giving and receiving to get what you need, not just buying and selling. Now we're out of time again. Join me again tomorrow as we will expound this some more. God bless you. Remember, God loves you. You are blessed and highly favored by the Lord.